Joe is holding the spinning wheel as shown, and he creates a torque by twisting his wrist upward. Which way does the wheel move? So Joe has a wheel sort of like this one with dowels on either side, and the wheel is spinning like this, and then he twists his wrist upward like this, creating a torque, and they want to know, does the wheel move to the right, or does it move to the left, or does it go straight up, or does it go straight down? You know, what is the direction of movement of the wheel? And so that's what we want to determine. So let's first consider the equation for angular momentum and torque impulse. The initial angular momentum plus the torque impulse is equal to the final angular momentum for the wheel. So let's first define the initial angular momentum direction. Well, this thing is spinning like this. So we take our right hand and curl our fingers in the direction of rotation, and our thumb points in the direction of the initial angular momentum, which is out of the board. So let's draw a vector diagram over here to the right, to Joe's right, that is, like this. And so this is L naught, like that. Now we need to get the direction for this torque impulse term. And once we have this torque impulse term as a vector, then we can just add these two vectorially to get the direction of the final angular momentum. Okay, so to do that, take your pencil on the exam. I'm going to take this bar because it's just easier for demonstration for you guys to see what's going on. And notice he takes his wrist and he puts a torque like this, right? He twists his wrist upward. So what direction is that torque? Well, notice that the bar, or on your exam, you'll have a pencil, the bar goes this way. So the direction of rotation of the bar, you just take your fingers and curl them in the direction of rotation of the bar, and your thumb points in the direction of this torque impulse, which is to Joe's right. It's that direction, right? Okay? And so this is the direction of the torque impulse, like so. Okay, so then we just add these two vectorially, and we see that we'll get something like this. So this will be L final. So initially the plane is pointing, you know, like this, right? But then in the final situation it moves over to the right. That seems sort of strange, doesn't it? And so let's do the experiment to verify it. So I'm going to take this wheel and get it spinning. Okay, and so I'm just going to take my wrist and twist them upward. Okay, so you saw that, it moved to the right. So I'm just going to twist my wrist upward just for a moment, just creating just that torque impulse just for, you know, a split second. And again, we see that it, you know, verifies our hypothesis, matches up with the experiment. So we know we're in good company. Okay, so this one shows up. Now, here's a trick. The angular momentum, the initial angular momentum, first thing you do is define this, right? Define that direction, draw a little vector diagram, define that. Then use that little trick with the bar, you know, use your pencil, and, you know, you twist it up like this, so it's rotating this way. Rotate your fingers in the direction of rotation of your pin, and that will give you the direction for this. The initial angular momentum always chases the torque impulse. Okay, it always chases the torque. Okay, so you know that it's going to be moving, you know, it's going to be going in the direction of this, right? Okay, and so the answer would be to Joe's right, would be one of the answers. And it's going to most likely, you know, 99.9% probability, this is going to be a conceptual question. They're spatially tricky. I would encourage you to practice. See you next time.